Hi Taurus, how are you? I hope that you guys are doing well. Please take care of yourselves. Stay safe, stay in the house. I'm in the house. And like I keep saying to everyone, I'm just afraid to go out right now with everything that's going on. So just know I'm so happy to be here with you guys and spend this time with you. Thank you for clicking on my video. My name is Lynn and this is Passion and Heart Tarot. If you guys are new to my channel, welcome. So this is your love reading, Taurus. So we're gonna take a look and see. I wanna take a look at your love life now. We're gonna look at the current state of your love life and your relationships or connections, and then we'll ask Spirit to show us what is coming in for April. All right, but before I do, just want to take a moment to invite the white light, the Holy Spirit. So this is flipping over as I shuffle. This is very significant. I'm gonna keep this in mind and I wanna see what other messages we get. Okay, let's see. So Taurus, your energy is here. So you could be dealing with another Taurus or a Libra. They're here as well. Or you could have that in your chart. Leo is here as well. So there's a so with the Tower card coming through, from what I can see, I know like a cycle got broken. I know someone cut something off. Absolutely, they did. They did. Because I see where this person is in the energy of like, I don't want to talk to you, I don't want to look at you. So a cycle definitely got broken here. There's so many aspects to it, because for some of you it's a connection. And when I say a connection, I know that sounds vague, because I know for some of you it could have been a friendship, it could have been something that was very impulsive, because I can see the energy of someone who kind of just lets their heart, emotions make their decisions for them. So some of you could be the one who is in that energy, who chose to end a connection. Okay, and because I just see where someone's guard is up. It's funny because at the same time, you have like these messages that are trying to come through of someone who wants to talk and show affection. That's what the energy is. It's like wanting to be next to this person, wanting to look into their eyes, hold them, that kind of thing. But it's like someone might not be open to that right now. And they're like sticking very strongly to their vows, morals, beliefs. It's being upheld here with this Taurus energy. And ultimately, strong Leo energies here. Ultimately, it's showing strength of character. And it's bringing so much happiness, because you know it's like a cycle's broken now, and it's broken, it's done. Tower is you don't really get a chance to turn that around. It's rare, and when you do, it's a blessing. But at the same time, it's also something that needs to end on a divine level, on a spiritual level, because it's for the well-being of everyone involved. So that came to an end. That's done. I see a lot of strength of character. I see where that's not going to be broken. Do you see that infinity symbol above this person's head? That's Spirit letting us know that like the strength that this person has found, they're not going to break it. It's a lesson, and it's like they pass, they get a badge. There's something very significant there that they should be proud of, or you can be proud of your person, because now, because of breaking that cycle, there's a lot of happiness, and there's being able to picture the future, someone being able to feel what they want. They can feel it and they can bring it to them. So there's a lot of optimism that's around you guys. I know it stems from a cycle breaking, something that needed to end. That door is closed, and now what's ahead of you is, I mean, what's around you now at least is very, very positive. So someone might be mad or upset. This person is not going to waver on what they want to uphold, because this is something that it's very deep. It's a deep sense of morals and traditions and wanting to do what's right. I want to look further into that Taurus energy. So this, as I shuffle, is flipping over. Again, more happiness, and it's at the expense of someone's heart being broken. So I wonder if some of you chose yourselves, chose to do what was right for you, even if you knew that it was going to hurt the other person by breaking the connection and walking away from them. Because I mean, that's what I can see. Although someone might pretend that they're fine, their heart is broken because of it. But you know what's crazy is that it brings so much happiness to someone else. So that's important for you to know, Taurus, because doing the what was best for you, walking away, you walked away from someone, or whoever this is, however you guys watch this, walking away was like it crushed this person. Might have even crushed you to do it, but it was the right thing to do. And it was something that was, it couldn't change. It was something that was destined to happen. Tower is like the divine stepping in and helping end something that maybe you didn't know how to end it. But it is now, and I can see where someone really has their guard up, but maybe that's for the best. Maybe that's for the best, because I can see where this person lets their emotions get carried away with them. So even if they thought that they were going to walk away and come back, they're not going to be able to. All right, I want to look at this. That's here. I see this Seven of Swords speaks very loudly to me, because it's a sneaky, sneaky energy. It's someone who, can become very emotionally removed when it suits them. So they can be manipulative. And they definitely don't always tell the truth. I mean, and that's to put it nicely about this person's energy. So you could have walked away from someone who's like this, Taurus, and wondering if it was the right thing to do, wondering if they, I know you're wondering if it was the right thing to do, but what I will tell you about that person's energy is like they may show you one thing when it suits them. That's what it is. Very manipulative. Like, I'll show you this side of me when I know that's what you need to see. So choosing to walk away and end it, just know that, I mean, what you have around you now, even if you don't realize it, that's why I like to look at the present, is you are not going to be broken again. And if you would just open the door, you could let so much sunshine into your life right now. Because there's so much positivity around you. Okay, let's ask spirit to show us what is coming in now. What's coming in for Taurus? So I can see the energy of Libra that's here. So again, you guys could be dealing with a Libra or Leo or have that in your chart. It's funny because as much as I shuffled, it's the same energy repeating over and over and over again. Just look at this, because you might have someone who keeps trying to call on this person to call them back. I can see there's the energy of someone who's still fighting, fighting for it, fighting for this person, fighting for the connection. So you may have someone that might not let you go, Taurus, or it could be however you guys watch this, you don't want to let them go. And I can see where they will try, they will, because what's controlling them now is their heart. They're not even thinking, same energy is repeating, they're not even thinking logically. So that's why it's so important to look at the present, because maybe someone needs to realize that, you know, they're not, that it is really done and they're not gonna turn and go back to it. Like, it's destroyed. It's, I want you to understand how deep that is, because it's a spiritual contract and just, it's broken, it's done, it's complete, it's not, it's ripped up. You're not gonna be able to tape it back together. And that's what someone fails to realize, because I see where they're still thinking of the possibility. They're still thinking that this, that okay, I walked away and I'm gonna be able to turn back and go to it. But that's not the case. That's not the case. So just know that you might have someone who you still, there's, because they're still trying to reach out to you, still sending messages or trying to find ways to do it, still in this energy of they're right, this belongs to me, and I'm gonna fight for it. And this is like, this is very volatile. It can lead to arguments, it can lead to someone saying things that are very, very harsh. So you know what the best thing for some of you to do is, if the if you find like this person, you're being inundated with messages from them and that they turn, because this can turn. This is someone who there's a violence in this person's energy, and that might not be physical. It could be like abusive, verbally abusive, or just like a lot of unwanted energy. If you find that that's what this person is doing, the best thing to do is to just cut off the communication with them, because they're not getting it through their head that this is done. They may even think that they're going to be able to manipulate their way back in, because they're just not thinking rationally at all. They're being driven by pure emotion. But I can see where someone is not going to break. And this is positive energy. It's like not being a victim again, not being taken advantage of again, and not ever realizing, you know, not realizing who they are and how they should be treated. The strength is eternal. It's forever. It's something that they earned through this connection, and it will not be taken away from them. I want to look into this Knight of Swords, because it's just like so angry, it's so aggressive, but at the same time, this person feels like they're fighting for what belongs to them. So let's see. I'm telling you can expect, because when I say a message being inundated, that's what this energy is right here. It's the thing that's messed up about it, that I'll tell you, is that this person is coming in with like what they believe are positive intentions. Like, I just want to talk to you, I just want to reach out to you. I, you know, this is what I have to say. It's very passionate, it's very loving in their head, at least that's what they feel. And I say in their head, because look at their energy that they're bringing in. This is not positive, although they think that it is, like sending message after message after message. So some of you are going to find out that you're going to have to block this person, because it's like nonstop, because I see the way that they want to talk, and I see the way that they feel and think that it's coming from a loving place. They don't realize that it is over, that it is done. They still think they can fight for it. And this is, it's manipulative. This coupled together is manipulative because it's like saying what they think you want to hear. It appears to be very affectionate, very attentive. Message after message, or phone call after phone call, or like however you communicate. It's even this person sending out that energy, like from their heart energetically into the universe. Like, they don't realize though that it's something that they're not going to be able to turn and go back to. So yeah, Taurus, it's kind of like a warning, especially if you recently let someone go. They're having a really hard time letting you go. And there's a lot of anger that's here. It's disguised though. That's the important thing is they'll send you something. It appears to be very sweet, but they're so mad when they're sending it to you. So that's important for you to know, to not be fooled. Because with the way someone is not thinking logically, you might slip into that energy as well of being susceptible of falling for it, of like giving them a chance to talk again. So that's why it's important for you to know the way that I can see it. Because they show you this, but you can't see them the way that I can see them because they're very angry and they're upset and they feel like almost entitled as if you belong to them. So you it's important for you to stand your ground. That's very important now. And some of you really might want to just block this person altogether. I want to look at this page of Wands. That's what it is, I'm telling you. It's someone who is thinking that if I just send them enough messages, I'm gonna be able to get things moving in the right direction. It's not really over. They still want a commitment, or whatever this is that they have in their mind. And I don't say that to be insulting, but I can see how irrational this person is. And I know how stressed out they are. But you have to be careful to not let their energy stress you out as well, because what you did by walking away, you closed one door. You might want to just put a lock on it and throw away the key, because keep that door closed. You have so much positivity around you now, and I can see where if you let this person come back in, they're just going to keep stressing you out over and over and over again. Because I know that someone, they have a commitment on their mind, like a forever kind of commitment, but it's coming from a very irrational place. So this is important for you guys to know. So important for you to stand your ground. And I tell you, like, I'm warning you about this person because I can see the way you could become susceptible to their energy again, because they are very manipulative and they know how to play on your emotions and beliefs. And you don't see what I see because you'll read the phone or talk to them and they're putting up a huge front because on the inside they're mad. Mad that you are not with them and mad because they feel like you belong to them. So don't fall for it. That's what I'm saying. All right, Taurus. So just know how much I love you guys. And I just want you to be careful when it comes to this person's energy. And I don't say that to be like, I say it very seriously because if you just look at the anger in this card, it's about someone very irrational because they feel like they're doing what's right. They feel like it belongs to them. And they're like gonna fight for it. They're having a very hard time letting go. Okay, so that's important, Taurus. Just know how much I love you guys. Please stay safe and be careful. Thank you for being here with me today. And if you haven't already subscribed, please do. I would really appreciate it. I wish you all the best, and I will talk to you very soon.